We'll drink horse barley beer and sit on your backstays and I'll whisper.
Katherine and I am an AmeriCorps service member and I serve with the Vermont Land Trust. The Vermont Land Trust is an organization that helps to conserve farmland and forest land and other types of land in the state of Vermont so that those places can stay farmland or forest land or can enjoy it for generations. So I love my job. I am in the education and outreach coordinator role here. That means I get to help connect young people and older people to the landscape even more through education. And I serve at a really cool place called Bluffside Farm. It's in Newport, Vermont. It is on the shore of Lake Memphremagog, which is a big, beautiful lake that we share with Canada. And I usually get to use the whole place as my classroom, but school is not in person right now, which is a bummer, but I just decided that I would help bring Bluffside Farm to you and we could learn a little on the way. So this is a place that I get to enjoy every single day, which I feel so lucky for. So come with me and you can enjoy it too and we'll learn about forests. In this video series, we're going to use Bluffside Farm as our classroom. We'll investigate forests and trees and all the cool things that make forests special in Vermont. What can you notice about forests, and what can it help you learn about the trees, plants, and animals around you? We're going to explore this together. For everyone following along at home, all you need is your observation skills and maybe paper and something to write with if you'd like to take notes. Maybe you'd rather color or doodle while you listen and watch. That's great too. There are guided reflections with every episode that are made to print out at home. If you don't have a printer, that's okay. You can look at the reflection on the screen and then copy it down onto some paper. The fun thing about this is that it does not have to be perfect. We are just going to explore our landscape and learn along the way. So, the first thing we're going to do when we are exploring the forest at Bluffside is just go for a walk. I'm going to go for some of my favorite walks and just enjoy the outdoors here. And try to find some of the best forested areas that I can find. And we'll just look around and see what we can find. Do we find any animals? Do we find any different types of trees? How do things look? What's different about the different places? And it's kind of cold today, so I have my big coat on. I'll probably get too hot as we walk. But then I might even go in some neighborhood streets. And we'll see what we can find there. The cool thing about Bluffside is that it's located in or really close to a lot of neighborhoods here. It's just a little bit down the street from the downtown of Newport. So not a lot of farms are located so close to cities. So it's a special place and it's cool to see what we can find this close to neighborhoods, houses, and a town. Let's go. I will tell you, my one disclaimer is that even though I really encourage you to go around your house, your yard, your area that you can go outside in right now,
are outside too right now. Outside in doesn't make any sense. Okay, start over. I encourage you to go outside where you can, safely, away from lots of people, and try to discover some of this along with me, wherever you can. That might be your front yard, might be backyard, woods, and you could probably ask your parents and look out for signs and be smart about where you're exploring. Maybe take a parent with you. And yeah, make sense? Cool.
As we explore, pay attention to signs of living and non-living things. Living things could be animals, plants, or even signs of animals, like the sounds that they make. Non-living things could be the amount of sunlight you see, wind, and water. Non-living and living things are both important and can tell us about the forest. I'll point out what I notice along the way. This is the first forested area that I explored on my walk. It is right next to a place near the lake called Scott's Cove, and I was looking around and I saw lots of shade, not a lot of sunlight. I saw mostly leaves covering the sky when I looked up. I could hear lots of birds. I could hear the breeze. And I could hear a lot of leaves in the wind up in the top of the trees, but I couldn't really feel the wind where I was. So those are the things that I saw, heard, and felt when I was here. Now we'll say goodbye to the forest near Scott's Cove, and we will keep walking along and see what other types of forests we can find. Now we are in a neighborhood forest across from Bluffside. I can see lots of sky, I can see lots of tree branches and lots of skinny tree trunks, and I can also see lots of leaves on the ground and even some animals and a porta potty. I could hear squirrels running on the ground, I could hear woodpeckers on the trees, and I could hear the wind, and I felt a lot of wind and snow when it started to snow a little bit.
I just saw a few deer. I'll show you the video in a little bit. You can see their white bottoms, the white-tailed deer. It's really exciting to see deer, especially in the middle of the day. Usually they come out at like dusk.
All right, now we are in our last stop in our Bluffside Forest Walk exploration. I see lots of sunlight right now coming through the branches. I see lots of forest floor, but I also see lots of smaller trees and some thorns. I can hear the birds here, but I can't really see them. And I can hear some breeze. I feel the sun on my skin. I feel the breeze and I feel those thorns snagging my pants. I wanted to show you where the last forest that we just looked at is located. It is pretty close to all the farm fields here at Bluffside. So you can see the trees in front of me kind of far away. That is where I was exploring just now.
It's so nice to go exploring in the sun and the snow and the wind when we've been cooped up inside for a while. I know I enjoyed that. So now that we've explored three different types of forest areas here at Bluffside, we're gonna put together all the stuff that we noticed and see what it can tell us about the parts of the forest.
Let's remember what we observed in the Scott's Cove Forest. We saw less sunlight and more shade. We saw lots of leaves covering the sky. We heard birds chirping and the breeze blowing the leaves of the trees up above, and we couldn't feel the wind. Why do you think the forest seemed darker and shadier? What made it so that the sky was covered? Pause the video and write or doodle some ideas for this question on the paper that you're using for notes. You can play the video again when you're ready to hear some thoughts. Remember how many leaves we saw covering the sky? It seemed to me like the forest was darker and shadier because of all the trees covering the sky. A word to describe those leaves is the canopy. The very tallest trees in a forest make up the canopy. If you hear someone describe the canopy as closed, that means lots of leaves and branches are covering up the sky. The forest is kind of closed to things like sunlight, rain, or snow. These things can still get in, but just not as much. If you hear someone describe the canopy as open, it means that the tallest trees are covering less of the sky. Sometimes the canopy is also called the overstory. Either term is correct, but I'll use canopy here in these episodes. This forest has a closed canopy. Remember how we heard birds chirping, but I couldn't see them? Maybe that's where the birds' chirps were coming from. Birds living up in those branches, the branches of the canopy. I couldn't feel the wind, and I think that's because the big tree trunks of those tall trees were blocking as much wind from coming into the forest. Now think about what we observed in the neighborhood forest across from Bluffside. We saw more sky, branches, and skinny tree trunks. We saw leaves on the ground and many animals, and we heard the animals too. We felt the wind and the snow coming through the forest. Why did the forest seem lighter here? What helped me see more sky and feel more wind? Pause the video and take a guess. Play it again when you're ready to hear my guess. Were you thinking that this forest had a more open canopy than the one before? I thought so too. That is what let in more wind, more light, and more snow. Remember how we noticed so many skinnier trees that were shorter than the ones in the forest by Scott's Cove? Remember how many animals we saw hanging out? All those squirrels, woodpeckers, and even deer? Why would animals want to hang out in a place with trees like that? If you want to, pause the video and give your best answer on your page or out loud. I wonder if the trees that are medium length are a good place for animals to hang out. Maybe they can find food in this layer, like the deer and the woodpecker. Maybe the squirrel hops through this layer in order to find and hide food. This part of the forest is called the midstory. You can remember it because it's kind of in the middle. The trees in the midstory may not reach all the way up to cover the sky, but they are the perfect place for animals to find a place to live or a habitat. Let's remember our final stop in the forest exploration. It was in the forest near the Bluffside Farm fields. We saw lots of sunlight here, small trees, thorn bushes, and some open forest floor. We heard birds chirping and we felt the breeze, the sunshine, and thorns pulling my pants. The sunlight coming through to the ground here shows us that the canopy was pretty open, even though there were some really tall trees too. For me, I had a hard time telling apart the midstory from the things that were even closer to the ground. Remember those short trees? The short trees that we saw growing and the thorns that I could feel pulling my pants were part of the layers of the forest called the understory and the floor. The understory is made up of the trees and other plants that are between about 5 feet and below. The plants might be things like shrubs or bushes. The forest floor is made up of the plants that are closest to the ground, from 0 to 5 feet tall. These could be plants like grass, moss, mushrooms, berries, or wildflowers. On the forest floor, you'll probably find many different types of plants growing in one place. That means that there is more diversity here. It might be confusing to tell apart the understory and the floor in the forest, but that's normal. Just do your best and remember that it might seem to overlap. Now we know what all the layers of the forest are called, but sometimes it's tricky to figure out where one layer starts and the other ends. Sometimes it's easier to tell than other times. This is because of a thing called disturbance. Disturbances in forests come from many different things. Sometimes they're natural, and sometimes they're man-made. What are some ideas that you can think of? I can think of fire, pests, disease, weather, like tornadoes or ice or wind. I can think of timber harvest to use the wood for different things, and I can think of agriculture, so taking down trees so that you can make a field to plant your farm in. In Vermont, a common cause of forest disturbance is agriculture, or clearing land to make room for farms. 80% of Vermont has been cleared in the past for farms, and now a lot of those trees are starting to grow back. When trees grow back, we see signs of ecological succession. Succession is when trees grow back in a certain order after a disturbance. When you understand the different parts of a forest, you can try to think about what might have happened to that forest in the past and why it has grown this way.
Oh my gosh. I feel like we just learned so much today. What do you think? I think we did a lot. So, together we explored 3 different forest areas at Bluffside Farm. We learned the terms canopy, open canopy, closed canopy. What else did we learn? We learned what the midstory is, the understory, and the forest floor. We talked about diversity a little bit, which was cool. And we also talked about ecological succession and disturbance. Yes. Those are all the things we talked about. And on the next little bit of this video, I have the words and definitions written out in case you want to copy them down and remember them for later. And you guys did a great job today. Thanks for coming around with me at Bluffside for a virtual little forest exploration. I had a lot of fun. It's been a lot of fun to make this video. And so next, what you can do is look for the guided reflection page. Don't worry, it's fun. And like I said, if you don't have a printer, you can just copy it off the screen and do your best. And yeah, maybe apply what you've learned today to the woods or the forest in your backyard, in your neighborhood, in your front yard. And make sure you check back next Friday at 11 a.m. There will be another video and another worksheet for episode 2 of Life in the Forest with Katherine from VLT. Bye, y'all.
We'll drink horse by the grave and sit on your backstays in a whispering. Try.